Hello students, how are you all? I hope you are all safe and healthy in your respective houses. Students, myself Santosh Patankar from Appa Public School. I am handling social science subject for the class 6th. Dear students, till 5th standard you have studied EVS and as well as social, but from this year, from 6th onwards, you are going to study the subject social science. This subject is called social science, and you know very well that in social science mainly there are three parts. First one is history, second one is civics, and third one is geography. Already I said you that in social science there are three parts. First one is history, second one is civics, and third one is geography. So today I am going to teach you the chapter which is belong to history part. So before starting my chapter, I want to tell you what is the meaning of social science. Do you know, children, what is the meaning of social science? Okay, social science means the scientific study of human society and social relationship. Social science means the scientific study of human society and social relationships. So this is the definition of social science, the scientific study of human society and social relationships. So now I am going to start the history part. The chapter name is What, Where, How, and When. So before starting this chapter, let us understand what of history. I said you already that today I am going to teach you the history part first lesson. So before that, we have to understand what is the meaning of history. So what do you mean by history? Dear students, history means the study of past, which is already over, that is called past. So in the history we are going to study about the past. So history means the study of past. And also in the word history you can see that his story. What is that? In the word history, his story. It means in the history we are going to study about the famous people, the famous rulers, and also we are studying about the famous kings and kingdoms. So history is very, very important subject. So in the history there are three. In the history there are three parts. First one is prehistory, second one is protohistory, and third one is history. We have divided in three parts. First one is Prehistory. Second one is protohistory. And third one is history. So let us see one by one. Already I said you, in history there are three parts. First one is prehistory, second one is protohistory, and third one is history. So what is prehistory? In the prehistory, the human beings, our ancestors, were not having the sense of reading and writing. They were not having any kind of education. They were not knowing how to write, what to write, where they have to write. So totally they were not having the knowledge about education. About the painting, they were painting, but they were not having the sense of reading and writing. Next, come to the protohistory. In the protohistory, the human beings were knowing about reading and writing. They were having little bit of knowledge about reading and writing, and they wrote some of the manuscripts and inscriptions. Already our archaeologists got it. But the thing is, our researchers did not understand the language what they have written. Understood, children? In the protohistory, human beings were having the sense of reading and writing, but they wrote some of the manuscripts and inscriptions, but our archaeologists unable to understand in which language they have written. Come to the third one, history. Already I said you, history means the study of past. Here, accurate years and incidents we can get here. But you can come to know about our kings and their kingdoms. Exactly we can study in this history part. How it is possible? Our archaeologists. So what do you mean by archaeologist? Archaeologist means the researchers who are always studying about the past. They are called archaeologists. So here in this history, completely you can study about what happened 1000 years ago, what happened 2000 years ago regarding AD and BC. So regarding AD and BC, I will tell you in the next class. So these are the three parts of history. First one is prehistory, second one is protohistory, and third one is history. This is the brief introduction of history. So in history part, today I am going to teach you the first lesson, what, where, how and when. The chapter name is what, where, how and when. See, children, already I said you that today I am going to teach you the chapter what, where, how and when. In this chapter, we are going to study about our ancestors. In this chapter, we are going to study about our past, how the people were there, what kind of food they were eating, where they were living. So in this chapter, many things we are going to study. So before that, in this chapter, four questions you have to ask yourself. If you ask four questions yourself, then completely you will come to know about this chapter. Completely you will get the knowledge of this chapter. So which are those four questions? Let me tell you. The first question is what to know. Where did they live? And the third question is, how was the life? And fourth question is, when it happened? See, children, already I said you that in this chapter you have to ask the four questions yourself. Then you will get the complete knowledge of this chapter. The first one is what to know. What to know about our ancestors? Where did they live? It means in which place our ancestors were living. How was the life? How was the life of our ancestors? How they were communicating each other? How was the culture? How was the tradition? How was the custom of our ancestors? And fourth one is, when it happened? So these are the four important questions in this. So if you ask yourself, then easily you will understand this chapter. Okay, children? See, children, every day, whatever the things are happening surrounding us, whatever the things are happening in the state level, national level, and in the international level, it means the information which is related to state level, national level, and international level, all the information you are getting. How are you getting? Can anybody say, children? Yes, all these informations we are getting through the media. Example, radio, newspaper, and television. Radio, newspaper, and third one is television. See, children, I said you already that all which are related to state level, national level, and international level, we come to know through the radio. So in the radio, we listen the news and we can come to know what the things are happening. But in the new generation, because the science and technology is developing, so nowadays people are not using the radio. But before our forefathers were using the radio and they were knowing what the things are happening. And second, newspaper. Dear students, early morning we read newspaper. So in the morning when we read newspaper, all the informations we can get in that. Information means which kind of informations? The informations which are related to politics, the informations which are related to weather or weather report or climate, and the information related to sports. So all the informations we are getting through the newspapers. And third one is television. Every day we watch news. So what we are getting the informations, all the informations we are getting through the news, news. So what do you mean by news? Can anybody say, children? N means north, E means east, W means west, and S means south. This is called news. We are getting the informations from all the four directions. So only this is, that is called news. There are so many news channels. Kannada news channels are there, Hindi news channels are there, and English news channels are there. In the news channels, we can get all the informations happening, whatever, all the informations we can get in the news by watching the news. So now, if I ask you, 1,000 years back, what happened? If I ask you 2,000 years back, what happened? 3,000 years back, what happened? So if I ask you the questions related to many years ago, that time what you have to do? Radio, newspaper, and television only the fresh informations. They are not giving the informations which are related to so many years ago. So that time, what you have to do? Can anybody say? You have to go through the history. History subject will give you the complete knowledge about our ancestors, about our past. So in this chapter, we are completely studying about our ancestors. So now the first point is, what can we know about our past? What can we know about our past? So here we are going to study, in this chapter we are going to study about our ancestors living, what kind of food they were eating, what kind of clothes they were wearing. So many things we are going to discuss here. This first one is food. So our ancestors, what kind of food they were eating? So today, if I ask you, what kind of food you are eating every day? So you will say that, sir, I am eating roti, chapati, vegetables, fruits, different food items, names you will say to me. So, but in the ancient time, 1,000 years back, in the stone age, what kind of food the people were eating? Can anybody guess, children? Okay, I will tell you. In the ancient time, the people were hunting. Hunting was the main occupation. Hunting was the main profession. So they were hunting the animals. Hunting means killing the animals for the food purpose. To get the food, they were hunting and they were killing the animals. So after killing the animals, what they were getting? They were getting raw flesh. In the ancient time, the people were eating raw flesh. Do you know what do you mean by raw flesh? Can anybody say, children? Okay, I will tell you. Raw flesh means after killing the animals, they were eating the meat of that animals without cooking, without boiling. Okay, raw flesh means the meat which is not cooked. that is called raw flesh. Dear students, today also many people are non-vegetarian, so they are also eating the meat, but they are cooking the meat. While cooking, they add so many ingredients in that and they boil it, and it will become delicious food. But in the olden days, our ancestors, they were not having the sense of cooking. They were not knowing up, they were not having the sense we have to cook the food, we have to boil the food before eating. But because of that reason, the people were hunting the animals, and after hunting the animals, they were eating the raw flesh. I already have said you, raw flesh means the meat which is not cooked, and this is raw. They were eating the raw flesh, and second, fruits. Dear students, our ancestors, they were living in the forest. They were not living in the villages. They were not living in the towns. They were not living in the cities. How we people are living now. So they were living in the forests. So generally, forest means so many plants were there, so many trees were there, and they were eating fruits. Different kinds of fruits they were getting from the plants and trees. They were eating different kinds of fruits. So they were eating all the varieties of food which were available in that forests. And next, always we discussed that they were eating the raw flesh, they were eating the fruits, and also they were eating roots and leaves. Roots and leaves. Dear children, the ancient people, they were eating roots and leaves. Today we people are not eating roots and leaves. But in the olden days, the people were totally depending on the food which was available in the forest. So they were eating roots and leaves. Today we have varieties of food items to eat. We cook different, you know. In Karnataka, if you say when we talk about Karnataka state, here different food items you can get. If you go to Bihar, there food system or food items are different. So according to the regions, according to the different places, the people prepare, the people cook different kinds of dishes. But in those days, the people were having very few selections. So because of that reason, they were hunting the animals, and they were eating the raw flesh, and they were eating the fruits which were naturally available in the forests, and also they were eating roots and leaves. Dear students, I said you that the people were hunting those days. They were chasing the animals and birds, and they were killing them. It means hunting them. But today, hunting is bad. Killing the animals is called offense. That is called illegal. So today we don't have right to hunt the animals. This is about the food what our ancestors were 18. Okay, children, have you understood? Okay. And now we are going to discuss about the clothes. Now we are going to discuss about the clothes. See, children, when we are talking about the clothes, so you know, children, according to the seasons, according to the three important seasons like summer, rainy, and winter, according to the climatic condition, according to the weather, according to the season, we wear different clothes. So when we speak about our ancestors, what kind of clothes they were wearing? Dear children, they were not having the sense of cotton. They were not having the sense of weaving. They were not at all knowing about the stitching the dresses. They were not knowing how to stitch, how to make cloth. It means weaving the cloth. So they were using the leaves. They were wearing the leaves. They were using leaves. See, children, in the winter season, naturally there will be more cold. So when there will be cold, nowadays in this modern generation, we are using woolen clothes like sweater. But those time, to cover the body and to get the protection from cold, from the winter, they were using the leaves. So clothes means, today I said you already that different clothes we are using, but in the olden days there was no option. They were using the leaves, and also we can say that they were killing the animals, and that skin they were using, the skin of the animals, also you can say the skin of the animals they were using their body. Okay, and now we are going to study about the hunters, about the gatherers. So let us study one by one. So in the ancient time, the people are divided into so many groups. The first one is hunters. Second one is gatherers. Third one is craft persons, etc. So I said you already that in the ancient time, the people were divided into so many groups. The first one, hunters. So what was the work of hunters? So already I said you in the beginning only, the people who are killing the animals, they are called hunters. Only their work is killing the. Second one, gatherers. So people, they were gathering in the same place because of their safety purpose. If the people are living together, the other animals cannot attack on them easily. And third one is craft persons. Craft persons means different works were doing, like stitching, weaving, painting, etc. So these kind of people were living in the ancient time, hunters, gatherers, and craft persons. So today, whatever the points we have discussed, children, today we have discussed that social science. What do you mean by social science? And after that, we understood what is history, and there are how many parts in history. Already I said you, there are three parts: prehistory, protohistory, and history. And after that, we have discussed about people, like what kind of food they were eating, what kind of clothes they were wearing, and also we have discussed about which kinds of people were living in the ancient time: hunters, gatherers, and craft persons. So today it is enough, children. The remaining thing we will discuss in the next class. Thank you.